Hey there, this is Jonathan Ross, and in the following tutorial we are going to take a look at setting up the presets for Illustrator. Now this is Illustrator 6, or CC, but it will also work with Illustrator CS6 and 5 and probably a few versions before that. But here's a couple things that we should check. Number one, if you go to your preferences, one of the things that I like to do is make sure that my general preferences are set to inches. And the reason why is because I live in America and I'm used to using inches. If you live somewhere else, you know, if you live somewhere that picas are the most common or centimeters are the most common, then of course you should set that up as the default for you. Anyway, when I go to a new document and I choose to use a print setting, and this is a very common one to use, there's a couple things wrong with it. Number one, I just set my page to, or my defaults to inches, but this document is set to points. So I'd have to change it physically on this setting when I go to it. Now the other thing is, you'll need to open up the advanced tab over here, and you want to change your color mode in all new documents that you create to RGB. We don't use CMYK colors anymore unless you're doing four color press jobs. Most of the things that you design, logos and business cards and brochures and posters and everything else, are going to be printed on digital printers or inkjet printers that even have a wider gamut of colors than CMYK. So it's very important that you give them an RGB file. So anyway, I'm going to create change it to inches and change the color mode to RGB. Now you'll see it says now the profile is set to custom, and we're going to change that later. Now there's a couple things that come in with those presets. You'll notice if I look over on the right, I get all these swatches. Well, I really don't want these swatches. So we also don't want brushes and symbols. We want to get rid of all that stuff so that the only thing that's in our file is the stuff that we want. So I'm going to go to the right menu, choose Select All Unused, and then click on the Delete Swatch button. It does leave behind a swatch here which says it's 0000 for CMYK, but let's get rid of that. And then it also leaves this other one called black. If you double click on it though, you'll see that this is not really a true black. So it's very important to take that back to a true black. Now, since I've been clicking around with stuff, I have changed some of my colors in here, and I think it's pretty important that we set this to a default that's going to work for us. So I'm going to click on white as my fill, black as my stroke, and then I'm going to click back on the fill so that when I open up this document in the future, that my fill color is the default type of fill that is selected. Now, we also need to go to brushes. Same thing, we go to the right, select all unused, delete all those brushes. Then we go to symbols, select all unused, hit the delete one, and then we do that with graphic styles. The reason we want all this stuff gone is because we want to be able to define our own swatches and brushes and symbols and graphic styles for the documents that we're working on, such as logos. We only want the colors that are associated with our logos in here. And it's really important that you deal with making swatches properly, especially global swatches, which I think are really the best in a lot of ways, and then spot color swatches when you need them for logos and other things like that. So anyway, I now have my document set up basically the way I want, and so I'm going to save this document. So I'm going to save it, actually, I've already got a file that I saved before. I'm saving it on the desktop as my defaults. And then just click OK with all the other stuff. Now I'd really like it that every time I open up Illustrator, I can use this default. Let me close that. So if I go to File, New, you'll see that I have the ability to actually go down to the bottom and choose Browse, and I can browse to that file right there. Now, the file on the desktop, though, I really don't think I'm going to leave this file on the desktop to use as my default file, because what if I move that file off the desktop? I'd really like to put it where files really belong. So I'm going to right click on this and I'm going to copy it, or I can even cut. Now I'm going to cancel that and come back and hit click on browse again. Oh man, I didn't think about the fact that I'm no longer on here, because it would typically take me to the folder where all the original files are, and I really didn't think about that. So, well, it doesn't really matter. What you want to do is you want to put this file somewhere you know where it is. So I'm going to cut it. I'm going to go to a file. Actually, it'll be under resources for me, and I will paste this here. And I'm going to click on it there and open that as my defaults. So now you'll see that my profile is called My Defaults, and I can create a new document anytime I want using those defaults. Next time I come back, I do File, New. It uses My Defaults by default, since that was my last file that I had, and I just click OK. Now, all bets are off, of course, if you delete or move that file. So I like to put it in the folder with the original presets, but as I clicked off of that folder already, it's not easy to show you that. So if you do want to find out where that is, you do want to put them in the proper place, then what you can do is search your computer for Illustrator preferences. So I'm going to go to my computer and I'm going to do search with Ultra Search, and it's Illustrator preference. Let's just look up Illustrator preferences. Let's see, hopefully it will remember what it was. That's it, Adobe Illustrator Prefs. And now I can open that containing folder, and here's actually the URL to it. Users, administrator, app data roaming, so you can see why I wouldn't remember. Then you have to go into New Document Profiles, and that's where it is. If I want to put my files in the right place for the New Document Profiles, that's where you put it, but it works just fine putting it somewhere else. Anyway, please do consider doing this with your documents. It just makes such a smarter way to work in Illustrator, getting rid of all that stuff that really is non-essential, and making sure that you're in inches and RGB color mode for every new document that you create. So let me know if you have any questions. Thanks.